Only on 12 News, it's been 6 months since a four-year-old girl was gunned down as she jumped rope in front of her home. Tonight, a glimmer of hope for the family of Jasmine Owens. The suspect in her killing is heading to prison on another charge. 12 News' Colleen Henry joins us from the newsroom. And Colleen, police have been targeting this suspect since Jasmine's death.
Yeah, Terry, sources tell 12 News that witnesses to Jasmine's shooting have been largely uncooperative, including the man police believe was the intended target of the bullet that killed the four-year-old. 12 News has learned a secret hearing called a John Doe has been underway to force witnesses to say what they know. 12 News has learned Judge Jeffrey Wagner has presided over an ongoing secret hearing called a John Doe in hopes of forcing witnesses to say what they know about the shooting that day last May.
I just seen a car drive by shooting. I didn't see no face. I just seen bullets flying.
Lorraine Johnson watched as her granddaughter Jasmine jumped rope, then collapsed after a bullet hit her in the head. Since then, the family has comforted itself with her pictures, her SpongeBob playset, and a coverlet bearing her likeness. But they've had little hope of finding her killer, till today.
The court will make a finding of guilt.
This afternoon, the 34-year-old man police suspect shot Jasmine pleaded no contest to shooting up a different house a week before Jasmine died. It was part of an ongoing gang dispute. A man now faces up to 5 years in prison in that shooting.
So just gonna just tell everything since he's opening up now. A little bit, gonna open up and tell it all.
As her family prepares to face its first Christmas without Jasmine, her grandmother hopes others will be less reluctant to tell what they know now that the suspect in her killing is going away. Or that maybe the holiday season will soften his heart.
Well, it was somebody in their family. His kids, his mama, sister, brother, somebody close to him.
Now that John Doe hearing continues. 12 News isn't naming the man since he hasn't been charged in Jasmine's death. He'll be sentenced in January on that earlier shooting. Three others were charged with him in the shooting up that house, Terry. They're awaiting sentencing too. Police and Jasmine's family hope his co-defendants may now be willing to testify against him in Jasmine's case.
Okay, Colleen, what do we know about this suspect?
Well, we know he's got a prior drug possession conviction. He's a suspected gangbanger, and the shooting he pleaded to today may have been part of an ongoing dispute that ultimately resulted in Jasmine's killing.
Terrible. Thanks, Colleen.